My name is Mike Marshall, and I'm the Senior Director of Digital with the Dallas Mavericks. This is Behind the Design, Part 1. Today we're going to reconstruct a piece that I call Wings. It's called Wings because the piece that it's modeled after was also called Wings. Pretty straightforward. It's this iconic Michael Jordan poster from 1989. Sorry, Tony Shalhoub. Okay, so like with any good edit, we're going to start by cropping out some source files. The original MJ piece might have been a real photograph, but I don't have that luxury. So we're going to try and recreate that black and white ultra real look with a composite. We obviously need to make Luka black and white, but the trick to black and white effects for me is a touch of highlights and shadows and a strong gradient map to smash that thing down and bring out some interesting contrast. We're going to throw in some inner shadow on Luka to make it appear as if the light source is only coming from one direction, which is in front of him. This background needs some work, so we're going to crank the lightness up and also put on a gradient overlay. So this piece is really three different edits in one for the final version. That was the first. So let's save that file. It doesn't matter that the shape of it is off and it's not quite perfect. We'll touch that up in the next edit. Let's touch up some of those shadows and highlights once again so that his skin tone is almost gray and the background pops a bit more. Okay, so here's the cool part. HDR toning. It can bring things out of a photo that you never knew were there. Alright, so we're cooking now, but still I don't like how it's blending towards the edges. So we're going to pull over this cool vignette overlay, drop it on top, and make the blending mode multiply to get that soft look. But it's still not dark enough around the borders, so instead of adjusting the brightness or contrast like a lot of people would, I like to crank up the gamma correction. Now we're going to slowly and softly take away some of that vignette effect around our focus area. Okay, so let's save this part, which would be edit number 2. Now you just have to do that 4 different times, adjusting for skin tone and realistic sizing of the player. But like any good cooking show, I'm gonna skip that part. Now we're on to the 3rd edit, which is sizing up the horizontal graphics we just made and fitting them on our board. I like using backgrounds that have familiar textures and leaving just enough to where the eye might catch it. This piece largely looks cool because of the scaling and the tricks that horizontal effect plays in your eyes. So I'll take a little extra time to do that. We were in Chicago on the last night of a 4-game road trip, and 8 days away from home usually makes me homesick. So I was listening to this Ben Harper album and a particular song called Having Wings. That was the conduit between Wings, Chicago, Michael Jordan, I Need to Make a Poster by Tomorrow, which ended up as this piece. And the final step in most of my projects is to flatten the image and add some gritty grain in there. Luckily, Photoshop has some really cool options in the filter gallery. And that is Wings, by me, with a little assist from Michael Jordan and Ben Harper.